Hello student, we have started unit number 2 and in last lecture we discussed the member of chlorophycin, and today we are going to continue the topic which is remaining in the chlorophycin. So as we know that chlorophycin is nothing but the organisms which is having green color in structure. That means they have green pigmentation prominently present in their cell or in their body. So they belongs to the chlorophycin, and the best example of this is nothing but the chara. So we have already discussed this chara, we have gone through the practical of this chara, and we have also seen that the chlorophycin is having 425 genera with more than 20,000 species discovered till date. The name green algae is given because the presence of dominant pigment like chlorophyll A and B over the carotenoids and xanthophylls. So chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B, these are the two pigment which is prominently present in this chlorophycin, and that's why this chlorophycin is the green in color, and that's why it is known as the green algae also. So chlorophytes or chlorophycin is known as green algae also. Now they are all eukaryotes. We have seen that how we call them eukaryotes, and how all the chlorophycin member are known as the eukaryote. Now we have gone through the occurrence of the this particular algae. Say for example, they are aquatic in nature. Aquatic means they are having the marine water system. They grow where in marine water. They also grow in the fresh water. Some member of the chlorophycin also shows growth in fresh water and marine water also. For example, the member of bivalves will show the growth in this fresh water and marine water also. Some of the algae shows the terrestrial growth. They grow in a swamp, and we can say some swamp area where the moisture is present. On that particular area also the growth of this chlorophycin algae occurs or shows. Along with that, they also grow on the subaerial part. For example, in the on the dead and decaying material, dead part of the plant, so they also act as a subaerial occurrence. They also occurred as a symbiotic association in the form of lichen. So majority of lichen, we can observe that they show the presence of chara or the member of the chlorophycin as a symbiotic association, and we called it as a lichen. Along with that, they also shows the growth as a epiphytic growth is observed in the chlorophycin. And the most important thing that occurs as a parasite, so majority of the structures you can see, they show the variety of occurrence, variety of the type of occurrence will observed in this chlorophycin. Say for example, aquatic, terrestrial, subaerial, epiphytic, symbiotic and parasitic mode of growth or occurrence will occur or observed in the chlorophycin member. So this is nothing but the occurrence we discussed in the last lecture. Along with this, we are going to discuss the systematic position. What the kingdom, it is included in the kingdom Plantae, then division Chlorophyta, class Chlorophyci, order Carrels, then family Carraceae, and genus is Chara. So it is the example or systematic position of Chara. So Chara is the most studied organism in the chlorophyci. So this is nothing but the systematic position. So most important thing is they are included in Plantae, Chlorophyta, then Chlorophyci, then Carrels, Carraceae and Chara. This is nothing but the systematic position of Chara, one of the most important and mostly studied organism of the chlorophyci. Now moving to the next, that is the reproduction. Reproduction in chlorophyci or member of the chlorophyci. Generally, there will be two types of reproduction is observed in the chlorophycin. One is known as vegetative reproduction and another is known as asexual reproduction. Beyond these two, sexual reproduction is also observed in the chlorophycin member. Vegetative reproduction is mostly done, or it is done by the process known as fission and fragmentation. In a fission, one cell get diffused, or it will separated, and it will considered as a fission process. And in this fission process, two cells are produced from the single cell. Likewise, fragmentation is the vegetative reproduction in which the vegetative structure get fragmented. The fragments itself separately act as a one new plant body, and this process is known as fragmentation. On the other hand, asexual reproduction is done by the two most important thing. One is nothing but the akinetes. Akinetes are the cells which is developed from the normal cell having the large coating, and these akinetes will separate from the parent cell and itself act as a new plant body when the favorable condition will occur. The same thing is there formation of endospore. These endospores are produced when the unfavorable conditions are there, and when the favorable condition appears, these endospores act as a new individual or new plant body. So when we talk about this asexual reproduction, mostly asexual reproduction in chlorophyce occur during the unfavorable condition, and when the favorable conditions occur again or happens again, the akinetes and the spores will start to reproduce. So these are the two most important reproductive structures or reproduction types in the chlorophyce, vegetative and asexual. Along with this, sexual reproduction is also observed in a majority of the member of the chlorophyce. Now, vegetative reproduction usually takes place by fragmentation. So, fragmentation will occur, and due to this fragmentation, vegetative reproduction occurs. Asexual reproduction is by flagellated zoospores and haplospores, peritations, akinetes, and lemmastage. So, these are nothing but the asexual reproduction. Akinetes is the most common method. Asexual reproduction is by mitospores. So they produce the structure that is having a thick wall, and they act as a asexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction shows considerable variation in the type and formation of sex cells, and it may be isogamous. So this is one type, isogamous type of reproduction. It is generally observed in Chlamydomonas, Eunothrix and Spirogyra. Then anisogamous, it is also observed in Chlamydomonas, Eudorinia. So this isogamous, anisogamous and oogamous is the third type of sexual reproduction. It is also observed in Chlamydomonas, Volvox, etc. So these three types of reproduction is commonly observed. Now we can say that Chlamydomonas shows the all three types of sexual reproduction, that is isogamous, anisogamous and oogamous. These are the types of formation of sex cells in that particular organism, and Chlamydomonas is one of them. That three type of sexual reproduction is observed in the Chlamydomonas. So we can say that isogamous and anisogamous, these are the two types which is mostly possible, or we can say common in the chlorophyce. The sole method of reproduction in Chlorella is asexual and azosporic. So it is the Chlorella particular. The content of the cell divides into non-motile spores known as autospores. These autospores are liberated by rupture of the parent cell wall. So it will liberate in the environment, and on release each autospores grow to become a new individual or new plant body. So this is nothing but the sexual reproduction. After sexual reproduction, what happens? The release of that autospores will produce the new plant body during the new season of the that particular year. Now, asexual reproduction in Chlorella is ellipsoids has been studied in detail, and the following four pages are or have been observed during the asexual reproduction. The first page, growth phase. During the growth phase, the cell grew in size by utilizing the photosynthetic product. So it is nothing but the growth phase. Second phase is known as the ripening phase. In this phase, the cell mature and prepare themselves for division. so the cell is ready to divide. Then post ripening phase. In post ripening phase, during this phase, each mature cell divides twice, either in dark or light. The cell formed in dark are known as dark to light phase. Cells again grow in size, and the fourth stage, that is nothing but the division phase. In division phase, what happens? The parent cell wall was ruptured, and the unicell get released from this particular pattern. So in this way, we can say that the four reproductive phases will observed, and these four reproductive phases are observed in asexual reproduction. What happens when the new plant will produce? This new plant will undergo the first phase, that is growth phase. Means it will become a grow, and it will become mature, and it will undergo the ripening phase. In ripening phase, what happens? The cell become mature and ready to reproduce. In post ripening phase, what happens? The cells are undergoing the reproduction or dividation. So it will divide twice. And in the last phase, that is division phase, the parent cell wall ruptures and unicell get released, and it will act as a new plant body. So in this way, the asexual reproduction was happen, or we can say overcome. So it is discussed in Chlorella. Chlorella is one of the organism of the chlorophyce, and it is mostly studied with the reference to this asexual reproduction. So in this way, we have discussed the two topics in today's lecture, that is the systematic position. Along with this, we have also gone through the reproduction in chlorophyce or member of chlorophyce, which is taken place by the three different ways, that is sexual reproduction, asexual reproduction, and vegetative reproduction. So watch this video two times to understand the concept of the reproduction and systematic position of chlorophyce. Thank you.